Welcome back to a new episode of
Jesse's Tips and Tricks.
Today we're going to look at hard limiting our audio in Adobe Audition. But as always, let's start off in Premiere. Here we have a first version of an edit. It's got everything. An interview, cutaway shots, good music, some nice breaks, corporate identity, some sweet visual effects, color grading, everything. And you've done the audio levels within Premiere. Looks like a perfect version to send off to a customer as a first draft. Before we export it, let's check the item one more time. Everything seems fine, when suddenly... the audio peaks into the red.
No!
But nothing that can be fixed, right? So we'll take the pen tool and yeah. Now it should be fine. Yeah, let's continue watching. Well, as you can see, this can be quite annoying and time-consuming. We thought our overall audio mix was good, and then these little moments of red. They ruin it for us. Since this is a first draft, there might be feedback from a customer. Some things on the timeline may have to be changed. We just don't want to spend great amounts of time editing our audio in Audition. We might want to do that for a final and approved version, but not for a first draft. Still, we want to deliver a high quality product, so we got to get rid of that rat. The laziest workaround is to go into the audio track mixer and turn down the volume of the master track until you're in the safe zone. Now we haven't really fixed the problem, we've just lowered the volume. And we can easily do better than that. So here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna export the audio, not in separate tracks, just the complete audio of our edit. Next, we'll open up the file in Adobe Audition. We select the whole thing by double-clicking it. We go to Effects, Amplitude, and Compression, and select Hard Limiter. In the window that pops up, you can set everything to default, except for Maximum Amplitude and Input Boost. What Maximum Amplitude does is that it actually cuts off everything that's louder than the amount you put in there. We usually set our maximum amplitude to -1. As you can see, most of the audio peaks around here, so we can safely boost the audio a bit here at Input Boost, taking into account that everything will be cut off at -1 dB. Now, click Apply, check if everything's okay, and right-click the track and select Save Selection As, adding -1 to the name. Import that file into Premiere, put it on a new track, check the solo track box, and there we are. There is no point where the audio is going to peek into the red at all. And it only took us a few seconds. Is this the way audio editing will be endorsed by an audio engineer?
Hell no.
But it was quick, easy, and the result was satisfying, right?
You're right.